Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to the After Effects. I'm Michael Carbonaro. Thank you so much for watching the Carbonaro Effect, our new episode, our first episode back. I am so excited about this season. I hope you are too. I've got questions that you guys wrote in at hashtag AskMichaelCarbonaro about this episode. So let's get going. Here we go. First question is from Aurora, who asks, this was a first great episode. Oh, thank you. How do you manage to keep coming up with cool stuff after all these episodes? My God, I have no idea. It is every time we go to make a new run of episodes, we're like, where are we gonna, how are we gonna, and I say we because this is a team effort. The answer is I don't know where it comes from, but it comes from somewhere. And it keeps happening, so I'm excited to keep funneling it to you. Okay, thanks, Aurora. Joe, what was your favorite trick from the audition room?
As I heard, it's a holiday show, so I brought Silent Night.
Okay, yeah. Perfect.
It has to be the sour notes when I was just singing off key and making the dogs howl, which isn't even magic, but it's so funny. Like, I loved doing that.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm.
And that woman, she was so sincere. She felt so bad for me that the dogs started howling.
That's my... I got distracted because I heard the dogs.
No, not
Is
at all.
Okay,
I was wondering what was happening myself. No, please.
Okay.
Begin again.
Allie writes in, how long have you been waiting to say we should have this on some kind of TV show or something?
Whoop.
That's insane.
I know, I dropped it. That's all. Silly me. Hold on. Wait, whoops.
Oh my God.
So let me see if I have a new one.
I can't believe it just did that.
Well, it because
that's hilarious. I wish I videotaped that.
Yeah, we should have this on some kind of TV show or something.
I've been waiting to say that my whole career. No, that was awesome. Yeah, I've been waiting, and it happened. We're so excited. Okay, Jake, who was the girl who played the witch slash black cat? She was pretty creepy. Yes, I like that you say that she played the witch and the black cat. She was a very versatile actress. She was able to portray a young woman, an old woman, and a cat. No, those were wonderful actresses that we found in Chicago too, and they weren't magicians, so we had to teach them that illusion, and that took a long time, and I have to say, it was executed really well.
So many memories here.
They do stay with you, don't they, Chris?
Oh, our final question from this episode is from Bear. Bear asks, in the final scene, you walked out during the actual magic, the woman turning old. Where do you actually go? Oh, yeah, I know, right? I'm always coming up with some reason to leave the room. I actually, for this one, I stepped out of the house and closed the door, but there was like a window and I was like watching. Just step outside and watch the fun too. That's when I get to actually be a spectator like you. And thank you for being spectators of this show. I love answering these, so tune in next week for an all new episode, brand new tricks, and it's super cool. If you wanna ask questions, you can write into Twitter or Facebook, maybe even Instagram. I don't even know if we've gone that far, but hashtag AskMichaelCarbonaro, and I'd love to see what you guys are thinking about the show. Thanks, man.